All right, everybody, we're back. I'm Jeff.
And I'm Jeff.
And welcome to the Gridiron. What we want to do right now, all right, we want to review, okay, all the games, okay, week 15. And there's some absolute beauts. We want to start off with our key game, and what a game, Miracle of the Meadowlands 2, it was between the Eagles and the Giants.
Woo! Good thing I picked it right, but,
Woo!
Giants.
Woo!
Lead. Whole game.
Woo!
Pretty much to the end there.
Woo!
Were they up by 21 at one point?
121. They were up by like 3 seconds ago.
Eagles rallied with like 8 minutes left. And then, as I'm sure everybody watching this video knows, Deshaun Jackson's punt return for a touchdown to win the game for him.
Yep.
It was a good game. Definitely expected it to be a good game.
It was.
Giants should have won.
Yep.
Didn't though.
Nope. What do you say? Giants, by the way, anything, sell like at a 95-yard, he'd be like a little dinker over the middle, of course, 10, 15 yards downfield. I mean, of course, every tight end, and, you know, could run 60, 70 yards without getting touched. Giants managed to do that.
Oh, yeah, because who was it? Ross, maybe? Somebody whiffed on a hit.
Yep.
He missed them.
Yep.
I mean, hit him there, I mean, you probably would have wasted another minute or so.
Oh, a couple minutes.
On that drive.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, there's so many things. I mean, then having the Bibber actually think there might be an onside kick when the Eagles are down by 2 touchdowns.
That's something you should expect. Yeah. Especially from the Eagles. I mean, they do it, not a lot, but more frequently than other teams, just surprising you.
Sure.
They did it a couple years ago against
the
Cowboys.
But they got to get the ball back. Yeah.
Yeah.
And, I mean, having the Bibber actually go back about 6, 7 years ago in the Meadowlands. Cold winter day. Giants up 10-7. About a minute and a half left to go. Giants decided to punt the ball to Brian Westbrook. If you're a Giant fan, you know what happened after that. Of course, Westbrook took the ball back for a touchdown. Eagles beat the Giants. Don't punt the ball out of bounds. Last time I checked, there wasn't a rule about kicking the ball out of bounds where actually the guy doesn't actually have to return the ball. Okay, don't kick it out of bounds. Just let him return for a touchdown. So here we are in the future. 2010, Miracle of Meadowlands 2.
It doesn't even matter how far you kick the ball.
Nah.
You just kick it out of bounds. I mean, you're going to waste at least 5 seconds just kicking the ball up.
Yeah.
Be about, 8 seconds left in the game.
Yeah.
I mean, most likely not going to score, especially with Nick.
Well, the only thing they could have done would have been one of two things. With, like, the way Vic was running, he would have had to run all the way in for a touchdown. Or it would have been, obviously, the Hail Mary. And the Giants,
he should have just not kicked the line drive, kick it straight up, waste 6-7 seconds just by the hang time.
Yeah, watch that way.
Instead of kicking a line
drive. He'll have to fair catch the ball.
Yeah.
Or kick it out of bounds.
Kick it over his head.
Yep. Well, so what we got is in about 30 years when they build a new mill, if I remember correctly, Meadowlands opened, the first one opened in 76. I believe it was the second season. We had Miracle of the Meadowlands 2. Well, so now we're opening up the new Meadowlands Stadium in the first year we're having Miracle of Meadowlands 2. So in about another 30 years when they open up another Meadowlands Stadium, it'll probably be about $10 billion by that point in time. Well, I'm sure somehow the Giants will manage to find a way to come up with Miracle of Meadowlands 3. So there'll be another Miracle of Meadowlands, folks, but you'll have to wait about 30 years for it. All right, well, on with the rest of the NFC games. Kansas City, I think. Castle, huge game. And Charles. Charles.
And the Thomas Jones.
Awesome. They whooped up on the Rams. It was a big game for the Rams, too. Big game for the Rams. Kansas City won 27-13.
Yeah, Detroit at Tampa Bay. Detroit was able to snap their winless streak.
Away
winless streak. Win in overtime, 23-20.
Then we had the... Carolina 19, Arizona 12.
Wow. And we had Dallas and Washington. Close game.
Ooh.
Didn't start out that way, but Dallas was able to come out on top 33-30.
Great game. All right, then we had Atlanta doing what you're supposed to do. An inferior team, and you go on the road, you win. Doesn't matter how, you win. They won 34-18.
And we had the Monday night game, Chicago winning 40, Minnesota 14.
It was good to see some snow, get the breath out of their mouths in Minnesota. Awesome, I hope.
Even though it was on a turf field.
Yeah, that was the only downer. But, I mean, hopefully when they build a new stadium, because they're trying to get a new stadium there,
Doubt Minnesota's going to make it outside.
I hope they do.
Mm-hmm. Man, grass.
Oh, yeah. Woo! Bring back the purple people ears. All right, now in the AFC, key game. Might have been another beaut. I'll tell you what. Indianapolis held on 34-24. Jacksonville rallied. Okay, to make it 27-24. Okay, and that's our oven. My wife's cleaning the oven. That beep going off lets us know the oven is nice and clean.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, oven.
It's been about 5 hours.
Good job. Yeah. Thanks, babe. Well, all right. Anyway, Jaguars climbed back within 27-24 late in the game. Onside kick. It happens once in a while. Usually the ball bounces around the center. Once in a while, it bounces right to a defending player, and your whole team is obviously charging for the ball. And when he catches it, if there's a little bit of a gap, he's going this way, you're coming this way, he goes right by, ain't nobody catching him. And the Colts wind up winning 34-24, put him in a tie, right, for the AFC South, same record.
Mm-hmm.
So, big game. Colts had to win that one. If they didn't win that one, probably weren't going to win the division.
Weren't going to make the playoffs.
And weren't even going to make the playoffs. That would have been one of the biggest stories of the year.
So it's like the Chargers this year.
Yes. So the Colts won in our key AFC game, 34-24 with the Jaguars.
All right. Thursday night game. Not too good of a game. We had San Diego beating San Fran 34-7.
It's like this Thursday night's game. In the beginning of season, I mean, it happens every year. What are you going to do? You know, in the beginning of season,
we expected San Diego to be in first. We expected San Fran to be in first.
Yeah. Expected this to be a big game.
Yeah.
Although San Fran, I mean, still had a shot. If they won, because Seattle lost, the Rams lost. If the 49ers won, the 49ers would have been right there. Mm-hmm. But it just goes to show you how inferior that division is. Chargers whooped up on them. And we had, I tell you what, if Miami can find an offense, they'll be pretty damn good. They got a well of a defense.
Mm-hmm.
Their offense. Wildcat ain't working.
You need a quarterback.
Need a quarterback. I mean, Ricky Williams, I think, is retiring this year. Supposedly he says that this year. But, I mean, you know, you got Brandon Marshall, you got Brown, you got a good offensive line, but, I mean, they need a quarterback. If they can find a little more offense, watch out for them, obviously, next year. Buffalo 17, Dolphins 14.
And we have Cincinnati coming out and actually winning a game.
Woo!
Beating Cleveland 19-17.
And we had Tennessee. They showed up, played a little bit of football. Huh? They beat the Texans 31-17.
All right, then we had Baltimore with a surprising win over New Orleans 30-24.
And we had the Jets. Wow! Look at them. They couldn't do anything against the Dolphins at home, but they go on the road and they squeak out. What a great game. Great game, finish. Pittsburgh, snow, grass, cold. You can't ask for anything better than that in December.
Yeah, going down the last play.
Oh, absolutely phenomenal. If Roethlisberger didn't get sacked in the end zone to get that safety, they would have been a field goal range.
That was key with Jason Taylor was offside.
Absolutely phenomenal. Safety. Jason Taylor could still bring it. Ready to go. Jets win in Pittsburgh 22-17.
All right, and we have Oakland beating up on Denver 39-23.
We did have Tebow set.
Looks good.
Yeah, alright, I like it.
Breaking some tackles for a nice 40-yard touchdown run.
Threw a couple nice passes. Mm-hmm. Tell you what, Orton, you're out of there. Alright, then we had, tell you what, that Sunday night game. I mean, I'll tell you what, backup quarterback for the Packers going to New England. New England hasn't lost there. 26 games in a row or something like that. Was Green Bay even going to come within 30 points? That was the biggest question. How much was Green Bay going to lose by? Well, if you bet 4 points, you would have been right. Everybody else would have been wrong. Now, what a phenomenal, phenomenal game. And Green Bay at the end of the game, marching down, they were around like the 20-25 yard line or so.
Yeah, but
clock was running. Tick, tick, tick.
They had a good time up, but then Flynn was being, you know,
just the inexperience. That's all that was. He couldn't get them. They should have easily got at least two plays if he You know, maybe could have spiked the ball, stopped the clock.
Even just ran a play.
Yeah, ran a play, something. You know, stop the clock. I mean, because when they got tackled, I think there was 24 seconds left to go on the clock. 24 seconds, you got one play off.
Yeah.
Should have got at least three. Could have possibly got four plays off.
Depending on how quick your passes were.
Exactly. And they're within touchdown.
And if you got out of bounds.
Yeah. Yep. Well, all right. Well, that's all the time we have right now. But when we come back, all right, we're going to preview Thursday night game. Carolina Panthers, Pittsburgh Steelers. But until then, I'm Jim.
And I'm Dan.
We're going to see you on the gridiron.